4 years ago, playing for someone else. I was playing keyboards. We met on the Amy Winehouse tour, supporting her. Musically, I've listened to a lot of Latin Spanish acts, but then the vinyls and the records that my dad always listened to at home were always soul or blues records or jazz records. So in that sense, my influence, my musical influence, was always more American, English. But the Spanish roots are always there. For any Spanish person leaving your country and doing well, you know, and being really proud of what you're doing, it means, like, you don't just wave the flag around. You're actually, you know, exporting a bit of your culture, and you're exporting a bit of the way we kind of are. And if we get to go and do that on a bigger stage and showcase to people, you know, then it is a big pride moment. I live in London. I've been here for 5 years, and I've been, you know, gigging up and down the country, going up and down the M1 a lot of times. And you know, it's where everything has begun. My first single, it started off with a very simple story. I lived in East London, and I was very hungover, and all I wanted was a big breakfast fry-up. That's all I wanted, and the English are pretty good for that. But I need something to eat. And today I reckon the weekend was very long. So I was just having my breakfast, looking at these builders and workers and different characters in this coffee shop. And then on the way home, just a 10-minute walk, sort of dazed and confused, I just hum melody. Little doo-doo, doo-doo kind of came to my head. And the song pretty much wrote itself within 20 minutes. I think our music is very uplifting soul, with a few influences from other genres, blues, pop, and the kind of timeless songwriters that I've listened to all my life. People like Paul Simon and James Taylor and Billy Joel. Ain't got no sunshine, ain't got no rain. I ain't got a worry in the world, but the blues remain. But yeah, I bring out my crazy ideas, and then we see what's good and what isn't, and we try stuff out. And it's like old school, you know, four guys in a shed playing stuff out.
Who's the nicest guy? Is this something
we search for new places to call our own.
I think the festivals in the summer in the UK were a real special experience, and people are just there, you know, who's this guy? Who's this hairy Spanish guy? And then you finish the show and they're really like gone onto the show, and you've just basically converted new fans, you know. When we heard about this award, it was completely unexpected, to get this recognition beyond your borders is a real privilege.
Thank you very much.